In particle physics, the Dirac equation is a relativistic wave equation derived by British physicist Paul Dirac in 1928. In its free form, or including electromagnetic interactions, it describes all spin minus one-half massive particles such as electrons and quarks for which parity is a symmetry. It is consistent with both the principles of quantum mechanics and the theory of special relativity, and was the first theory to account fully for special relativity in the context of quantum mechanics. It was validated by accounting for the fine details of the hydrogen spectrum in a completely rigorous way. The equation also implied the existence of a new form of matter, antimatter, previously unsuspected and unobserved and which was experimentally confirmed several years later. It also provided a theoretical justification for the introduction of several component wave functions in Pauli's phenomenological theory of spin. The wave functions in the Dirac theory are vectors of four complex numbers known as bispinors, two of which resemble the Pauli wave function in the non-relativistic limit, in contrast to the Schrödinger equation which described wave functions of only one complex value. Moreover, in the limit of zero mass, the Dirac equation reduces to the Weyl equation. Although Dirac did not at first fully appreciate the importance of his results, the entailed explanation of spin as a consequence of the union of quantum mechanics and relativity—and the eventual discovery of the positron—represents one of the great triumphs of theoretical physics. This accomplishment has been described as fully on a par with the works of Newton, Maxwell, and Einstein before him. In the context of quantum field theory, the Dirac equation is reinterpreted to describe quantum fields corresponding to spin minus one-half particles. Mathematical formulation. The Dirac equation in the form originally proposed by Dirac is where psi equals psi x, t is the wave function for the electron of rest mass m with spacetime coordinates x, t. The p1, p2, p3 are the components of the momentum, understood to be the momentum operator in the Schrödinger equation. Also, c is the speed of light, and h is the Planck constant divided by 2 pi. These fundamental physical constants reflect special relativity and quantum mechanics, respectively. Dirac's purpose in casting this equation was to explain the behavior of the relativistically moving electron, and so to allow the atom to be treated in a manner consistent with relativity. His rather modest hope was that the corrections introduced this way might have a bearing on the problem of atomic spectra. Up until that time, attempts to make the old quantum theory of the atom compatible with the theory of relativity, attempts based on discretizing the angular momentum stored in the electron's possibly non-circular orbit of the atomic nucleus, had failed, and the new quantum mechanics of Heisenberg, Pauli, Jordan, Schrödinger, and Dirac himself had not developed sufficiently to treat this problem. Although Dirac's original intentions were satisfied, his equation had far deeper implications for the structure of matter and introduced new mathematical classes of objects that are now essential elements of fundamental physics. The new elements in this equation are the 4×4 matrices alpha k and beta, and the four-component wave function psi. There are four components in psi because the evaluation of it at any given point in configuration space is a bispinor. It is interpreted as a superposition of a spin-up electron, a spin-down electron, a spin-up positron, and a spin-down positron. See below for further discussion. The 4×4 matrices alpha k and beta are all Hermitian and have squares equal to the identity matrix alpha I 2 equals beta 2 equals I 4. Display style alpha underscore I caret 2 equals beta caret 2 equals I underscore 4, and they all mutually anticommute if I and j are distinct. Alpha I alpha j plus alpha j alpha I equals 0. Display style alpha underscore I alpha underscore j plus alpha underscore j alpha underscore I equals 0. Alpha I beta plus beta alpha I equals 0. Display style alpha underscore I beta plus beta alpha underscore I equals 0. The single symbolic equation thus unravels into four coupled linear first-order partial differential equations for the four quantities that make up the wave function. These matrices and the form of the wave function have a deep mathematical significance. The algebraic structure represented by the gamma matrices had been created some 50 years earlier by the English mathematician W. K. Clifford. In turn, Clifford's ideas had emerged from the mid-19th century work of the German mathematician Hermann Grassmann in his lineal Ostenningsler theory of linear extensions. The latter had been regarded as well-nigh incomprehensible by most of his contemporaries. The appearance of something so seemingly abstract, at such a late date, and in such a direct physical manner, is one of the most remarkable chapters in the history of physics.
Making the Schrödinger equation relativistic.
The Dirac equation is superficially similar to the Schrödinger equation for a massive free particle. Minus 2 m 2 phi equals I t phi display style frac hbar caret 2 meters nabla caret 2 phi equals I hbar frac partial t phi. The left side represents the square of the momentum operator divided by twice the mass, which is the non-relativistic kinetic energy. Because relativity treats space and time as a whole, a relativistic generalization of this equation requires that space and time derivatives must enter symmetrically as they do in the Maxwell equations that govern the behavior of light—the equations must be differentially of the same order in space and time. In relativity, the momentum and the energies are the space and time parts of a spacetime vector, the four momentum, and they are related by the relativistically invariant relation E 2 equals m 2 c 4 plus p 2 c 2 display style e caret 2 equals m caret 2 c caret 4 plus p caret 2 c caret 2, which says that the length of this 4 vector is proportional to the rest mass m. Substituting the operator equivalence of the energy and momentum from the Schrödinger theory, we get the Klein-Gordon equation describing the propagation of waves, constructed from relativistically invariant objects. Minus 1 c 2 2 t 2 plus 2 phi equals m 2 c 2 phi display style left frac 1 c caret 2 frac partial caret 2 partial t caret 2 plus nabla caret 2 right phi equals frac m caret 2 c caret 2 hbar caret 2 phi. With the wave function phi being a relativistic scalar, a complex number which has the same numerical value in all frames of reference. Space and time derivatives both enter to second order. This has a telling consequence for the interpretation of the equation. Because the equation is second order in the time derivative, one must specify initial values both of the wave function itself and of its first time derivative in order to solve definite problems. Since both may be specified more or less arbitrarily, the wave function cannot maintain its former role of determining the probability density of finding the electron in a given state of motion. In the Schrödinger theory, the probability density is given by the positive definite expression rho equals phi displaystyle rho equals phi caret asterisk phi, and this density is convected according to the probability current vector j equals minus I 2 m phi minus phi display style j equals frac I hbar 2 meters phi caret asterisk nabla phi nabla phi caret asterisk. With the conservation of probability current and density following from the continuity equation j plus rho t equals 0. Display style
nabla
c dot j plus
frac
partial
rho
partial t
equals 0.
The fact that the density is positive, definite, and convected according to this continuity equation implies that we may integrate the density over a certain domain and set the total to 1, and this condition will be maintained by the conservation law. A proper relativistic theory with a probability density current must also share this feature. Now, if we wish to maintain the notion of a convected density, then we must generalize the Schrödinger expression of the density and current so that space and time derivatives again enter symmetrically in relation to the scalar wave function. We are allowed to keep the Schrödinger expression for the current, but must replace the probability density by the symmetrically formed expression ρ equals I 2 m c 2 psi t psi minus psi t psi
display style
rho equals
frac
I hbar
2 mc
caret
2
psi
caret
asterisk
partial underscore
t psi
psi
partial underscore
t psi
caret
asterisk,
which now becomes the fourth component of a spacetime vector, and the entire probability 4 current density has the relativistically covariant expression J mu equals I 2 m psi mu psi minus psi mu psi.
Display style
j caret
mu
equals
frac
I
hbar
2
meters
psi
caret
asterisk
partial
caret
mu
psi
psi
partial
caret
mu
psi
caret
asterisk.
The continuity equation is as before. Everything is compatible with relativity now, but we see immediately that the expression for the density is no longer positive definite. The initial values of both psi and t psi may be freely chosen, and the density may thus become negative, something that is impossible for a legitimate probability density. Thus, we cannot get a simple generalization of the Schrödinger equation under the naive assumption that the wave function is a relativistic scalar, and the equation it satisfies, second order in time. Although it is not a successful relativistic generalization of the Schrödinger equation, this equation is resurrected in the context of quantum field theory, where it is known as the Klein-Gordon equation, and describes a spinless particle field, e.g. pi meson or Higgs boson. Historically, Schrödinger himself arrived at this equation before the one that bears his name but soon discarded it. In the context of quantum field theory, the indefinite density is understood to correspond to the charge density, which can be positive or negative, and not the probability density. Dirac's coup.
Dirac thus thought to try an equation that was first order in both space and time. One could, for example, formally, i.e. by abuse of notation, take the relativistic expression for the energy E equals C P 2 plus M 2 C 2. Display style E equals C sqrt P caret 2 plus M caret 2 C caret 2. Replace P by its operator equivalent, expand the square root in an infinite series of derivative operators, set up an eigenvalue problem, then solve the equation formally by iterations. Most physicists had little faith in such a process, even if it were technically possible. As the story goes, Dirac was staring into the fireplace at Cambridge, pondering this problem, when he hit upon the idea of taking the square root of the wave operator thus 2 minus 1 c 2 2 t 2 equals a x plus b y plus c z plus I c d t a x plus b y plus c z plus I c d t. Display style
nabla caret 2
frac
1
c caret 2
frac
partial caret 2
partial t caret 2
equals
left
a
partial underscore
x plus
b partial
underscore
y
plus
c
partial
underscore
z
plus
frac
I
c
d
partial
underscore
t
right
left
a
partial
underscore
x plus
b
partial
underscore
y
plus
c
partial
underscore
z
plus
frac
I
c
d
partial
underscore
t right. On
multiplying
out the
right
side, we
see that,
in order
to get
all
the
cross terms
such as
x, y
to
vanish, we
must
assume
a
b
plus
b
a
equals
0.
Display
style
a
b
plus
b a
equals
0,
L dots
with
a
2
equals
b
2.
equals
1.
Display
style
a
caret
2
equals
b caret
2
equals
L dots
equals
1.
Dirac,
who had
just
then
been
intensely
involved
with
working
out
the
foundations
of
Heisenberg's
matrix
mechanics,
immediately
understood
that
these
conditions
could
be
met
if a,
b,
c
and
d
are
matrices,
with
the
implication
that
the wave
function
has
multiple
components.
This
immediately
explained
the appearance
of
two-component
wave
functions
in
Pauli's
phenomenological
theory
of spin,
something
that
up
until
then
had
been
regarded
as
mysterious,
even
to
Pauli
himself.
However,
one
needs
at
least
4×4
matrices
to
set
up
a
system
with
the
properties
required.
So
the
wave
function
had
four
components,
not
two,
as
in
the
Pauli
theory,
or
one,
as
in
the
bare
Schrödinger
theory.
The
four-component
wave
function
represents
a
new
class
of
mathematical
object
in
physical
theories
that
makes
its first
appearance
here.
Given
the
factorization
in
terms
of
these
matrices,
one
can now
write
down
immediately
an
equation
a
x
plus
b
y
plus
c
z
plus
I
c
d
T
psi
equals
kappa
psi.
Display style
left
a
partial
underscore
x plus
b
partial
underscore
y
plus
c
partial
underscore
z
plus
frac
I
c
d
partial
underscore
t right
psi
equals
kappa
psi,
with
kappa
to be
determined.
Applying
again
the
matrix
operator
on
both sides
yields
2
minus
1
c
2
t
2
psi
equals
kappa
2
psi.
Display
style
left
nabla
caret
2
frac
1
c caret
2
partial
underscore
t
caret
2
right
psi
equals
kappa
caret
2
psi.
On
taking
kappa
equals
mc
h,
we find
that
all
the
components
of the
wave function
individually
satisfy
the
relativistic
energy-momentum
relation.
Thus
the
sought-for
equation
that
is first
order
in both
space
and
time
is
a
x
plus
b
y
plus
c
z
plus
I
c
d
t
minus
m
c
psi
equals
0.
Display
style
left
a
partial
underscore
x plus
b
partial
underscore
y
plus
c
partial
underscore
z
plus
frac
I
c
d
partial
underscore
t
frac
mc
h bar
right
psi
equals
0.
Setting
a
equals
I
beta
alpha
1
b
equals
I
beta
alpha
2
c
equals
I
beta
alpha
3
d
equals
beta.
Display
style
a
equals
I
beta
alpha
underscore
1
b
equals
I beta
alpha
underscore
2
c
equals
I beta
alpha
underscore
3
d
equals
beta.
And
because
d
2
equals
beta
2 equals I 4 display style d caret 2 equals beta caret 2 equals I underscore 4. We get the Dirac equation as written above. Topic: covariant form and relativistic invariance. To demonstrate the relativistic invariance of the equation, it is advantageous to cast it into a form in which the space and time derivatives appear on an equal footing. New matrices are introduced as follows: d equals gamma 0 display style d equals gamma caret 0 a equals I gamma 1 b equals I gamma 2 c equals I gamma 3 display style a equals I gamma caret 1 b equals I gamma caret 2 c equals I gamma caret 3 and the equation takes the form, remembering the definition of the covariant components of the four gradient and especially that 0 equals 1 ct, where there is an implied summation over the values of the twice repeated index mu equals 0 1 2 3 and mu is the four gradient. In practice, one often writes the gamma matrices in terms of 2 times 2 sub-matrices taken from the Pauli matrices and the 2 times 2 identity matrix. Explicitly, the standard representation is gamma 0 equals I 2 0 0 minus I 2 gamma 1 equals 0 sigma x minus sigma x 0 gamma 2 equals 0 sigma y minus sigma y 0 gamma 3 equals 0 sigma z minus sigma z 0 display style gamma caret 0 equals begin p matrix I underscore 2 and 0 0 and I underscore 2 end p matrix gamma caret 1 equals left begin array c 0 and sigma underscore x sigma underscore x and 0 end array right gamma caret 2 equals left begin array c 0 and sigma underscore y sigma underscore y and 0 end array right gamma caret 3 equals left begin array c 0 and sigma underscore z sigma underscore z and 0 end array right. The complete system is summarized using the Minkowski metric on spacetime in the form gamma mu gamma nu equals 2 eta mu nu I 4 display style gamma caret mu gamma caret nu equals 2 eta caret mu nu I underscore 4 where the bracket expression a b equals a b plus b a display style a b equals ab plus b a denotes the anticommutator. These are the defining relations of a Clifford algebra over a pseudo-orthogonal four-dimensional space with metric signature plus minus minus minus. The specific Clifford algebra employed in the Dirac equation is known today as the Dirac algebra. Although not recognized as such by Dirac at the time the equation was formulated, in hindsight the introduction of this geometric algebra represents an enormous stride forward in the development of quantum theory. The Dirac equation may now be interpreted as an eigenvalue equation, where the rest mass is proportional to an eigenvalue of the four-momentum operator, the proportionality constant being the speed of light p o p psi equals m c psi. Display style p underscore mathrm op psi equals mc psi. Using equals d e f gamma mu mu Display style partial stackrel mathrm def equals gamma caret mu partial underscore mu display style partial big is pronounced d slash. According to Feynman slash notation, the Dirac equation becomes I psi minus m c psi equals 0. Display style I HBAR partial big psimic psi equals 0. In practice, physicists often use units of measure such that h topic c 1, known as natural units. The equation then takes the simple form. A fundamental theorem states that if two distinct sets of matrices are given that both satisfy the Clifford relations, then they are connected to each other by a similarity transformation. Gamma mu equals s minus 1 gamma mu s display style gamma caret mu prime equals s caret minus 1 gamma caret mu s. If in addition the matrices are all unitary, as are the Dirac set, then S itself is unitary. Gamma mu equals U gamma mu U display style gamma caret mu prime equals U caret dagger gamma caret mu U. The transformation U is unique up to a multiplicative factor of absolute value 1. Let us now imagine a Lorentz transformation to have been performed on the space and time coordinates, and on the derivative operators, which form a covariant vector. For the operator gmu to remain invariant, the gammas must transform among themselves as a contravariant vector with respect to their spacetime index. These new gammas will themselves satisfy the Clifford relations, because of the orthogonality of the Lorentz transformation. By the fundamental theorem, we may replace the new set by the old set subject to a unitary transformation. In the new frame, remembering that the rest mass is a relativistic scalar, the Dirac equation will then take the form I U gamma mu U mu minus M psi x t equals 0. Display style U caret dagger gamma caret mu U partial underscore mu caret prime M psi x caret prime T caret prime equals 0 U I gamma mu mu minus M U psi x T equals 0. Display style U caret dagger I gamma caret mu partial underscore mu caret prime M U psi x caret prime T caret prime equals 0. If we now define the transformed spinner psi equals U psi display style psi caret prime equals U psi, then we have the transformed Dirac equation in a way that demonstrates manifest relativistic invariance. I gamma mu mu minus m psi x t equals 0. Display style I gamma caret mu partial underscore mu caret prime m psi caret prime x caret prime t caret prime equals 0. Thus, once we settle on any unitary representation of the gammas, it is final provided we transform the spinner according to the unitary transformation that corresponds to the given Lorentz transformation. The various representations of the Dirac matrices employed will bring into focus particular aspects of the physical content in the Dirac wave function, see below. The representation shown here is known as the standard representation. In it, the wave function's upper two components go over into Pauli's two-spinner wave function in the limit of low energies and small velocities in comparison to light. The considerations above reveal the origin of the gammas in geometry, hearkening back to Grassmann's original motivation. They represent a fixed basis of unit vectors in spacetime. Similarly, products of the gammas such as GMGN represent oriented surface elements, and so on. With this in mind, we can find the form of the unit volume element on spacetime in terms of the gammas as follows. By definition, it is V equals 1 4 E mu nu alpha beta gamma mu gamma nu gamma alpha gamma beta display style V equals frac 1 4 epsilon underscore mu nu alpha beta gamma caret mu gamma caret nu gamma caret alpha gamma caret beta. For this to be an invariant, the epsilon symbol must be a tensor, and so must contain a factor of square root g, where g is the determinant of the metric tensor. Since this is negative, that factor is imaginary. Thus, v equals I gamma 0 gamma 1 gamma 2 gamma 3 display style V equals I gamma caret 0 gamma caret 1 gamma caret 2 gamma caret 3. This matrix is given the special symbol gamma 5, owing to its importance when one is considering improper transformations of spacetime, that is, those that change the orientation of the basis vectors. In the standard representation, it is gamma 5 equals 0 I 2 I 2 0, display style gamma underscore 5 equals begin P matrix 0 and I underscore 2 and 0 end P matrix. This matrix will also be found to anticommute with the other four Dirac matrices, gamma 5 gamma mu plus gamma mu gamma 5 equals 0 display style gamma caret 5 gamma caret mu plus gamma caret mu gamma caret 5 equals 0. It takes a leading role when questions of parity arise because the volume element as a directed magnitude changes sign under a spacetime reflection. Taking the positive square root above thus amounts to choosing a handedness convention on spacetime. Topic: conservation of probability current. By defining the adjoint spinner psi equals psi gamma 0 display style bar psi equals psi caret dagger gamma caret 0, where psi is the conjugate transpose of psi, and noticing that gamma mu gamma 0 equals gamma 0 gamma mu display style gamma caret mu caret dagger gamma caret 0 equals gamma caret 0 gamma caret mu. We obtain, by taking the Hermitian conjugate of the Dirac equation and multiplying from the right by gamma 0, the adjoint equation psi minus I gamma mu mu minus m equals 0. Display style bar psi I gamma caret mu partial underscore mu m equals 0, where mu is understood to act to the left. Multiplying the Dirac equation by psi from the left and the adjoint equation by psi from the right and subtracting produces the law of conservation of the Dirac current mu psi gamma mu psi equals 0. Display style partial underscore mu left bar psi gamma caret mu psi right equals 0. Now we see the great advantage of the first order equation over the one Schrödinger had tried. This is the conserved current density required by relativistic invariance. Only now its fourth component is positive definite and thus suitable for the role of a probability density. J 0 equals psi gamma 0 psi equals psi psi display style j caret 0 equals bar psi gamma caret 0 psi equals psi caret dagger psi. Because the probability density now appears as the fourth component of a relativistic vector and not a simple scalar as in the Schrödinger equation, it will be subject to the usual effects of the Lorentz transformations such as time dilation. Thus, for example, atomic processes that are observed as rates, will necessarily be adjusted in a way consistent with relativity, while those involving the measurement of energy and momentum, which themselves form a relativistic vector, will undergo parallel adjustment which preserves the relativistic covariance of the observed values.
Solutions.
See Dirac spinner for details of solutions to the Dirac equation. Note that since the Dirac operator acts on four tuples of square integrable functions, its solutions should be members of the same Hilbert space. The fact that the energies of the solutions do not have a lower bound is unexpected. See the whole theory section below for more details.
Topic: Comparison with the Pauli theory.
The necessity of introducing half-integer spin goes back experimentally to the results of the Stern-Gerlach experiment. A beam of atoms is run through a strong inhomogeneous magnetic field, which then splits into n parts depending on the intrinsic angular momentum of the atoms. It was found that for silver atoms, the beam was split in two. The ground state therefore could not be integer, because even if the intrinsic angular momentum of the atoms were as small as possible, 1, the beam would be split into three parts, corresponding to atoms with Lz.
Minus 1, 0, plus 1. The conclusion is that silver atoms have net intrinsic angular momentum of 1/2. Pauli set up a theory which explained this splitting by introducing a two-component wave function and a corresponding correction term in the Hamiltonian, representing a semi-classical coupling of this wave function to an applied magnetic field, as so in SI units. Note that bold-faced characters imply Euclidean vectors in three dimensions, whereas the Minkowski four-vector A mu can be defined as A mu.
Phi C A H equals 1 2 M Sigma P minus E A 2 plus E Phi. Display style H equals FRAC 1 2 meters left bold symbol sigma CDOT left Math BF PE Math BF O right carrot 2 plus E Phi. Here A and Phi display style Phi represent the components of the electromagnetic four potential in their standard SI units, and the three sigmas are the Pauli matrices. On squaring out the first term, a residual interaction with the magnetic field is found, along with the usual classical Hamiltonian of a charged particle interacting with an applied field in SI units. H equals 1 2 m p minus e a 2 plus e phi minus E 2 M Sigma B display style H equals FRAC 1 2 meters left Math BF PE Math BF a right carrot 2 plus E Phi FRAC E HBAR 2 meters bold symbol Sigma CDOT Math BF B. This Hamiltonian is now a 2×2 matrix, so the Schrödinger equation based on it must use a two-component wave function. On introducing the external electromagnetic four-vector potential into the Dirac equation in a similar way, known as minimal coupling, it takes the form gamma mu I mu minus e a mu minus m c psi equals 0. Display style gamma caret mu I HBAR partial underscore mu A underscore mu mc psi equals 0. A second application of the Dirac operator will now reproduce the Pauli term exactly as before, because the spatial Dirac matrices multiplied by I have the same squaring and commutation properties as the Pauli matrices. What is more, the value of the gyromagnetic ratio of the electron, standing in front of Pauli's new term, is explained from first principles. This was a major achievement of the Dirac equation and gave physicists great faith in its overall correctness. There is more, however. The Pauli theory may be seen as the low-energy limit of the Dirac theory in the following manner. First, the equation is written in the form of coupled equations for two spinors with the SI units restored. M C 2 minus E plus E phi C sigma P minus E A minus C sigma P minus E A M C 2 plus E minus E phi psi plus psi minus equals O display style begin P matrix mit caret 2 E plus E phi and C bold symbol sigma C dot left math BF P E math BF a right C bold symbol sigma C dot left math BF P E math BF a right and left mit caret 2 plus E E phi right end P matrix begin P matrix psi underscore plus psi underscore end P matrix equals begin P matrix 0 end P matrix. So E minus E phi psi plus minus C sigma P minus E A psi minus equals M C 2 psi plus display style ee phi psi underscore plus c bold symbol sigma c dot left math bf p e math bf a right psi underscore equals mit caret 2 psi underscore plus minus e phi psi minus plus c sigma P minus E A psi plus equals M C 2 psi minus display style E E phi psi underscore plus C bold symbol sigma C dot left math BF P E math BF a right psi underscore plus equals mit caret 2 psi underscore. Assuming the field is weak and the motion of the electron non-relativist. I see, we have the total energy of the electron approximately equal to its rest energy, and the momentum going over to the classical value E minus E phi approximately equals M C 2 display style EE phi approximately mc caret 2 P approximately equals M V display style math BF P approximately M math BF V. And so the second equation may be written psi minus approximately equals 1 2 M C sigma P minus E A psi plus display style psi underscore approximately frac 1 2 mc bold symbol sigma c dot left math bf p e math bf a right psi underscore plus which is of order v c. Thus, at typical energies and velocities, the bottom components of the Dirac spinner in the standard representation are much suppressed in comparison to the top components. Substituting this expression into the first equation gives, after some rearrangement, E minus M C 2 psi plus equals 1 2 M sigma P minus E A 2 psi plus E
phi psi plus display style emit caret 2 psi underscore plus equals frac 1 2 meters left bold symbol sigma c dot left math bf p e math bf a right caret 2 psi underscore plus e phi psi underscore plus. The operator on the left represents the particle energy reduced by its rest energy, which is just the classical energy, so we recover Pauli's theory if we identify his two-spinner with the top components of the Dirac spinner in the non-relativistic approximation. A further approximation gives the Schrödinger equation as the limit of the Pauli theory. Thus, the Schrödinger equation may be seen as the far non-relativistic approximation of the Dirac equation when one may neglect spin and work only at low energies and velocities. This also was a great triumph for the new equation, as it traced the mysterious I that appears in it, and the necessity of a complex wave function, back to the geometry of spacetime through the Dirac algebra. It also highlights why the Schrödinger equation, although superficially in the form of a diffusion equation, actually represents the propagation of waves. It should be strongly emphasized that this separation of the Dirac spinner into large and small components depends explicitly on a low-energy approximation. The entire Dirac spinner represents an irreducible whole, and the components we have just neglected to arrive at the Pauli theory will bring in new phenomena in the relativistic regime, antimatter and the idea of creation and annihilation of particles. Topic: Comparison with the Weyl theory. In the limit M0, the Dirac equation reduces to the Weyl equation, which describes relativistic massless spin 1/2 particles.
Dirac Lagrangian.
Both the Dirac equation and the adjoint Dirac equation can be obtained from varying the action with a specific Lagrangian density that is given by L equals I C psi gamma mu mu psi minus M C 2 psi psi display style math call L equals I HBAR C overline psi gamma caret mu partial underscore mu psi mit caret 2 overline psi psi. If one varies this with respect to psi, one gets the adjoint Dirac equation. Meanwhile, if one varies this with respect to psi, one gets the Dirac equation.
Topic: Physical interpretation. Topic: Identification of observables.
The critical physical question in a quantum theory is, what are the physically observable quantities defined by the theory? According to the postulates of quantum mechanics, such quantities are defined by Hermitian operators that act on the Hilbert space of possible states of a system. The eigenvalues of these operators are then the possible results of measuring the corresponding physical quantity. In the Schrödinger theory, the simplest such object is the overall Hamiltonian, which represents the total energy of the system. If we wish to maintain this interpretation on passing to the Dirac theory, we must take the Hamiltonian to be H equals gamma 0 M C 2 plus C gamma K minus Q A K plus Q A 0 display style H equals gamma caret 0 left mit caret 2 plus C gamma caret K left P underscore K Q A underscore K right plus Q A caret 0, where, as always, there is an implied summation over the twice repeated index K.
Topic 1, 2, 3. This looks promising, because we see by inspection the rest energy of the particle and, in case A
0, the energy of a charge placed in an electric potential QA 0.
What about the term involving the vector potential? In classical electrodynamics, the energy of a charge moving in an applied potential is H equals C P minus Q A 2 plus M 2 C 2 plus Q A 0. Display style H equals C SQRT left PQA right carrot 2 plus M carrot 2 C carrot 2 plus QA carrot 0. Thus, the Dirac Hamiltonian is fundamentally distinguished from its classical counterpart, and we must take great care to correctly identify what is observable in this theory. Much of the apparently paradoxical behavior implied by the Dirac equation amounts to a misidentification of these observables. Topic: Hole theory. The negative E solutions to the equation are problematic, for it was assumed that the particle has a positive energy. Mathematically speaking, however, there seems to be no reason for us to reject the negative energy solutions. Since they exist, we cannot simply ignore them, for once we include the interaction between the electron and the electromagnetic field, any electron placed in a positive energy eigenstate would decay into negative energy eigenstates of successively lower energy. Real electrons obviously do not behave in this way, or they would disappear by emitting energy in the form of photons. To cope with this problem, Dirac introduced the hypothesis, known as Hole theory, that the vacuum is the many-body quantum state in which all the negative energy electron eigenstates are occupied. This description of the vacuum as a sea of electrons is called the Dirac sea. Since the Pauli exclusion principle forbids electrons from occupying the same state, any additional electron would be forced to occupy a positive energy eigenstate, and positive energy electrons would be forbidden from decaying into negative energy eigenstates. If an electron is forbidden from simultaneously occupying positive energy and negative energy eigenstates, then the feature known as zitterbewegung, which arises from the interference of positive energy and negative energy states, would have to be considered to be an unphysical prediction of time-dependent Dirac theory. This conclusion may be inferred from the explanation of Hole theory given in the preceding paragraph. Recent results have been published in Nature R. Jaritsma, G. Kirchmeyer, F. Zeringer, E. Solano, R. Blatt, and C. Ruse, Nature 463, 68-71, 2010, in which the zitterbewegung feature was simulated in a trapped ion experiment. This experiment impacts the whole interpretation if one infers that the physics laboratory experiment is not merely a check on the mathematical correctness of a Dirac equation solution but the measurement of a real effect whose detectability in electron physics is still beyond reach. Dirac further reasoned that if the negative energy eigenstates are incompletely filled, each unoccupied eigenstate, called a hole, would behave like a positively charged particle. The hole possesses a positive energy since energy is required to create a particle-hole pair from the vacuum. As noted above, Dirac initially thought that the hole might be the proton, but Hermann Weyl pointed out that the hole should behave as if it had the same mass as an electron, whereas the proton is over 1800 times heavier. The hole was eventually identified as the positron, experimentally discovered by Carl Anderson in 1932. It is not entirely satisfactory to describe the vacuum using an infinite sea of negative energy electrons. The infinitely negative contributions from the sea of negative energy electrons have to be cancelled by an infinite positive bare energy, and the contribution to the charge density and current coming from the sea of negative energy electrons is exactly cancelled by an infinite positive jellium background, so that the net electric charge density of the vacuum is zero. In quantum field theory, a Bogoliubov transformation on the creation and annihilation operators, turning an occupied negative energy electron state into an unoccupied positive energy positron state and an unoccupied negative energy electron state into an occupied positive energy positron state, allows us to bypass the Dirac-C formalism, even though, formally, it is equivalent to it. In certain applications of condensed matter physics, however, the underlying concepts of Hole theory are valid. The sea of conduction electrons in an electrical conductor, called a Fermi sea, contains electrons with energies up to the chemical potential of the system. An unfilled state in the Fermi sea behaves like a positively charged electron, though it is referred to as a hole, rather than a positron. The negative charge of the Fermi C is balanced by the positively charged ionic lattice of the material.
In quantum field theory.
In quantum field theories such as quantum electrodynamics, the Dirac field is subject to a process of second quantization, which resolves some of the paradoxical features of the equation.
Other formulations.
The Dirac equation can be formulated in a number of other ways.
As a differential equation in one real component.
Generically, if a certain linear function of electromagnetic field does not vanish identically, three out of four components of the spinor function in the Dirac equation can be algebraically eliminated, yielding an equivalent fourth-order partial differential equation for just one component. Furthermore, this remaining component can be made real by a gauge transform.
Curved spacetime.
This article has developed the Dirac equation in flat spacetime according to special relativity. It is possible to formulate the Dirac equation in curved spacetime.
The algebra of physical space.
This article developed the Dirac equation using four vectors and Schrödinger operators. The Dirac equation in the algebra of physical space uses a Clifford algebra over the real numbers, a type of geometric algebra.
In polar form.
For the Dirac spinor, it is possible to show that one can always find local Lorentz transformations for which the spinor is written in the so-called polar form, that is the form manifesting only two physical degrees of freedom, given by the scalar and pseudo-scalar bilinear quantities. The Dirac spinor field equation can always be written in the corresponding polar form, which is the form specifying all derivatives of the scalar and pseudo-scalar bilinear quantities themselves. In this formulation, the Dirac spinor field equation, which are four complex equations, and so eight equations in total, is converted into an equivalent system of two real vector equations, which are two four-dimensional equations, and so again eight equations in total. This is what is known as the polar form of the Dirac equation.
See also.
The Dirac equation appears on the floor of Westminster Abbey on the plaque commemorating Paul Dirac's life, which was unveiled on 13 November 1995.